Hi, welcome to episode 17 of 501. Today we're in my beloved hometown of London on the beautiful River Thames. Not the first time we've been here, obviously, in the 17 so far, but after the madness of Leicester and Fox and Locks and a little bit of a serene, quaint little village like Bourneville, it's time to come home. Today we're going to be tripping all the way down the South Bank from here right up to Tower Bridge. I can't tell you about all the places because some of them are individual places. But we're going to have a look at some places such as the Hayward Gallery, the National Theatre. We're going to also look at Tower Bridge, the Udderbelly, which is a favourite destination of mine, and just the South Bank on the whole. One of the best places to visit in London. So come join us. We've got a special guest with us today. We'll reveal all in a couple of minutes. So yes, part 17 is well and truly started. Hello, Mom. It's not creepy at all. Oh, all right. Yes, so today's guest, wearing purple, quite fittingly, because we're going to the Purple Cow, is Miss Kate Wallington. Welcome. We missed you on the last trip. You were supposed to be there, but now you're here. Bubbles all over me. And there's a bear. Oh, and there's a scream. Hi. And that kid did exactly what it was supposed to, scream. Right, so here we are at my favorite part of London, without a doubt. You can't go anywhere better, in my opinion, because everything is here. You've got the London Eye there, brilliant. Got the tourist attractions over there, Westminster Abbey, where the royal wedding took place a couple of weeks ago, which is very nice. On this patch of grass, I've had many a good picnic and afternoon just lazing in the sunshine. We're going to see loads of stuff down there. You can get a Thames clipper boat from there, which is one of my favourite things to do. You get that down to the O2. And also, if we just swing it round, you get the Udderbelly, which is the big purple cow.
Can't miss it.
Yes. That noise is the real noise of the Purple Cow. I'll tell you a bit more about the Purple Cow when we're in there. Very, very special place for me. Probably my favourite bar in the whole of London. But unfortunately, it's only there for a couple of months every year. So you have to really enjoy it while you're there. Massive Jenga, massive Connect Four, massive time. Yeah, as you can see, this is the section of the South Bank where you get a lot of street performers. Some of them good, some of them not so good. I mean, that guy's trying to make bubbles, that's not really exciting. But then there are people who do some real good stuff that you'd see, like, across the world in the Ramblers or in Edinburgh, like we saw last year. So we're going to continue now to the Udderbelly. We're going to have a drink. We're going to learn some lines because we've got a show on this week. That's why we've got the world-famous Kate Wallington here with us this week, the actress extraordinaire. Then after the lines, we're going to carry on walking. We're going to see Gabriel's Wharf. We're going to see the Tate Modern that we saw last time and loads of other things. So stay with us. Don't click on to poke somebody on Facebook. Keep watching. Now that's magic. Where was the other chair?
Thank you very much.
Right, now this guy's not really doing it for me. Steady on, it's not worth it, mate. It's not worth it. If you'd have taken the other chair, I might have given you 50p. Yeah.
It's your favorite.
Right.
Do you want me to do it again? Ready?
Yeah.
And go.
So here we are at the Udderbelly. I've got my Connect Four piece because in a little bit I'm going to whip Kate Wallington's ass at a game of Connect Four, life size. Funny because Kate's wearing purple and I'm wearing purple today. I didn't even realise we'd come to the big purple cow. But basically, the Purple Cow is a very special place in my heart because the first time I ever went there was in Edinburgh, my first ever Edinburgh Festival. And then they brought it down to London for the last couple of summers. It comes here between May and July, and everyone can come out in the summer, watch Wimbledon. Last year we watched the World Cup here. Don't know why we bothered though, to be honest, and got absolutely pissed on. Rain, and there was chaps all around us. But it usually brings nice clientele. You can come out in the daytime in the summer, have a few pints, look at the London Eye, and then play Connect Four and Giant Jenga. And have a nice drink in the Magnus pasture. So yeah, we're going to have a few games, stay here for a bit more, and then we're going to make our way down through the beach festival that's going on at the moment currently in the main part of the Southbank. So you'll probably see us playing.
We'll see Paul getting his ass whipped as well.
Dirty Essex bird, Kay Wallerton, is losing heavily.
Shut up.
She can't play. Shit.
Shut up. You haven't got any proof. You've got proof that you've won two. You cheated, actually.
Yeah, that's lies. It's all
you
lies.
You cheated, everyone.
It's all lies. The sun is out and we are ready to play.
Yeah.
Oh, she's out. All right, well, there you go.
What hell?
And here we are on the beach. Oh, and what's this? Let's have a look in here. Oh, brilliant. He's gone. What a joker. No one knew. No one knew.
I just would that.
Oh, what's that up there? See, this is what the South Bank's all about. Loads of shit and you don't know what it is.
I had my essay from last year.
What, loads of shit and you don't know what it is?
Yeah.
Well.
Flying around there.
You need how good it was. Need to,
yeah, that's my dissertation. There it is.
Essex!
This is an Essex coastal beach hut, and this is an Essex coastal beach slut. I couldn't say it because I was too excited about saying it. Look, it's just like being in Essex. The only way. Back in old Seawick, or Jaywick, or Valley Farm.
Yeah.
Oh, whacker banker.
Where's Paul? Ah!
Go away!
No.
Get out of here! In 1945, the war ended. And the Royal Navy saved the day. Look at my ship. And then in 2011, I came to the South Bank 50 years ago when I did this story. 50 years ago. 2009. And even worse than that, I've just seen this book. Cloud Atlas. Do you remember that, St. Mary's students? Do you remember it? I do, because it was shit. It was shit. That's why I did Speak Softly, She Can Hear, because Cloud Atlas was shit. Get out of my hut now. Get out now. Get out of my boutique store. Get out.
And there he is, Urban Fox, part of the summer festival. Made completely out of hay. And that's not part of it. It's a pigeon. And then over there, standing patiently in the sunshine, smiling away, is that guy from the Hayward Gallery. But also is Kate Wallington. Who's enjoying the South Bank treat?
I'm loving it today.
In the sunshine.
And there's the world, you
can
see.
Yeah, see it from everywhere. This is the Hayward Gallery. So there's many galleries, many arty-farty stuff down here, including a couple of theatres, a couple of festival halls, a couple of galleries. Me and you, we're very arty-farty. Yes, indeed. and it's currently a summer festival here at the on the South Bank.
Summer breeze.
The saddest fox in the world. Warhorse is still on, yes it is. It's come back. Oh! That's the bell which signifies I've got to stop filming. But,
one step.
This is the National Theatre. It's one of the best theatres in the world, but it is one of the most ugliest, in my opinion. In the summer, they put a lot of grass and big chairs out, which makes it slightly better. But, it isn't. It's so 70s, it's so concrete, and it looks like shit, to be honest. And Kate's now demonstrating her acting skills of going up some stairs. History Boys, you know, History Boys on here. This is one of my favourite shows. There, right in there, in there.
James Corden.
And Smithy.
What was the other guy? Who's in Mamma Mia?
Dominic Cooper.
Dominic Cooper.
Yeah, that's the guy.
The original crew.
Yeah.
And a bus.
And a bus. With the Udderbelly on it. With the Udderbelly, look, that's where we were.
Now open. Where are you going?
I'm walking.
Alright, go on then.
Right, so here we are. This is one of the best things you can do in London. Just take a stroll on an old afternoon down the South Bank. And, you know, the music's playing, you'd think you were in Paris the way it was going on. Oh, it's beautiful. Alright, fuck up. Right, so we're now going to walk towards the Oxo Tower, which is not where they make gravy cubes. It's actually a very, very famous and very expensive restaurant. So sorry, Kate, we're not going there for lunch. Maybe next time. But yeah, you can walk down here. It's a long stretch by the River Thames, the famous Thames, as the Americans call it. And we're going to go past some of the things we've already seen before, like the Tate Modern and St. Paul's Cathedral. But we're going to go to Gabriel's Wharf now, I believe, which is where they filmed this morning. And also where we're going to try and get something to eat. So,
nom noms.
A bit away from the Parisian feel.
So I literally needed her.
Oh, and that's the, I don't know who they are, but that's the London studios where they film all the shows like Ant and Dec, Saturday Night Takeaway and Daybreak and things like that.
This morning?
Yes, well this morning's actually a bit further down, but that's...
Oh, thanks for pointing that out on camera now. You could have just made me look good, but no.
No, no. Well...
Get on with it.
To the next place. We go.
Yeah, you're on your own. I'm going down to have some chow.
So one of the bad things about the South Bank at the moment is they're rebuilding Blackfriars Station, so you can't walk straight down, you have to go on a bit of a round the houses diversion. But you know, that's a small price to pay when you still get views like this when you come back. Look at all that rubbish, what a view.
Talking to me.
What a view.
What a view.
Look at that arse.
Check out my
that's a pure The Only Way is Essex, a toey. That's a toey phrase.
That is pure Essex.
What about a mick though? Is it a mick saying?
A mick saying?
Yeah, made in Chelsea, it's the new one. No. See, when you watch this back in 2030, you'll think, oh yeah, I remember that pile of shit. How did that ever get commissioned? Although I don't know what we'll be watching in 2030, so. We were here last time, there's the Millennium Bridge and St. Paul's Cathedral. And then, see all the candidates for The Apprentice walking across there probably, because that starts tonight. Happy days, new series. You're fired.
Stop plugging.
I'm not, I don't.
Be plugging our show.
Oh yeah, Post Dawn Gallop. Well, no one's going to see it because this hasn't got to go onto Facebook till afterwards.
Well.
And there's the Tate Modern that we saw last week.
Last week.
And then seeing as we are actors, I think we should go to somewhere where you can do a bit of acting. How about
the National?
Well, oh yeah, well that's true. How about a bit of Shakespeare's Globe?
Yes, please.
Well, let's get the fuck out of here then. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is Christopher Wren's house. Obviously not anymore because he's dead. But when he used to live here, yeah. Ooh. And basically in there is where he inspired the genius. It's a little inconspicuous building next to the Globe, which we'll see in a second.
It has got a nice garden terrace.
I don't know if that was there at the time, but that's where he used to look out and gaze across the Thames over to his finest creation, probably one of his most recognised pieces, St Paul's Cathedral. So there you go.
Praise be with you, Matthew.
Yeah.
Can we go to the Globe now?
Yes, let's go to the Globe. I know you're still rubbing your knees in excitement. Bit of Globe action. They love the Globe. Yes, Shakespeare.
It's just in. Don't feel me. Mind the bollard.
And there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Shakespeare's Globe Theatre. I went there last year for the first ever time and saw... I can't remember what it was. It was that good. I think it was Macbeth.
Or mate. You're not supposed to say it.
No, it's only when you're on stage.
We're on stage this week. Fuck's
sake. Yep, that's right, folks. Well, that's the Financial Times, where I did my work experience as a 16-year-old boy. And it's
I walked away from you.
I knew. I saw.
No, it's not about me. It's about your day today.
So it is about the day today. It's about trip number 17 of 501.
I don't think I've been on any of the others.
You haven't, no. So this is your first one.
First one.
Are you enjoying it?
It took me a while, didn't it?
Yeah, it did. That's a great imaginary watch you had there.
That's good acting.
But this is basically the Southbank. It's coming to an end now. But you just it's all about walking along the Thames at a canter, maybe.
I'd say a mild trot.
A stroll would be a good word. Conquering all the bridges, crossing over, getting all of
the
delights that the Thames has to offer.
Flippers,
at your own pace, but you have to have a day. You have to set aside a day for this kind of thing. There's pubs along the way. We found one. We went to Doggett's.
Lush food and drink.
We went Doggett's.
A little bit pricey though. We went Doggett's. Yes.
Doggett's. Yes.
No car parks involved.
No. Just Doggett's. Pure Doggett's. And there's the Shard, which is going to be a massive building when it's finished. Wonderful. Oh, and then we come here. This is the Clink, but I can't really talk about.
Games, Karen, okay.
It's a Nando's. There is a Nando's here. Unlike
for jazz now.
Jazz. Get your jazz and get your Nando's. Around here, it's very old-fashioned. I like it around here. But there's the Clink Museum, and that's another trip, I think. So we can't talk about that today. We have to talk about that another day. So we'll come back for that. You'll see that later. And then there's some cool people just walking on the cobbles. Oh, the Golden Hind as well. We'll see that in a second.
Yes, the Golden Hind.
Looking for the Golden
nice.
Hind.
Not as much as the Globe, but...
No, don't touch your legs again.
No, I don't need to.
You don't need to.
They're on fire now. Burnt them out.
Oh, Wagamamas as well. Wow.
Joe Kersley. Wagamamas.
Joe Kersley, Wagamamas.
I'll get you all
Karen
in here.
Karen Kaza White.
Get you all
Nando's.
Tagged on Facebook.
Yeah, tag them all. Tag all the bastards.
Like a Pokemon.
Oh, Premier Inn. Yeah. I stayed there.
We can't tag you again.
Yeah, me again. And an ice cream van. Maybe we should get an ice cream, but not them prices.
Often licked, but never beaten. How dare you use that?
Again, you can take the girl out of Essex. You can't take Essex out of the girl.
Oh, never. I'll always be a toey.
A toey. Get your toey out. Dip your toey. Right, so we're coming to the end of our adventure along the South Bank. And I felt a lot more comfortable than when I walked in Leicester and got lost. So thanks for being here to help make sure I didn't get lost.
No problem.
On the South Bank. And there we go, there's the Clink, just to show you, but we'll be... Oh, the camera won't focus. That's obviously because it doesn't want us to see it till next time. And there, ladies and gentlemen, is Sir Francis Drake's famous galleon, the Golden Hind. Right, there you go. So one look at Southwark Cathedral and then we're out of here. And that's time up.
Let's
until
roll.
The next time.